Hi and welcome to a quick video about the Laravel certification program. I've just recently passed this program this week, so I thought I'd give a bit of help to anyone who's currently studying for it or thinking about doing it, because there's not really that much information about what you should prep for. So I'm just going to give a quick overview of how the exam works and what specific topics I would recommend that you look at. So I've been developing with Laravel for about 4 years, and I did about an hour's preparation before I took the exam. It seemed to be enough for me, but I'm not sure if it would be enough for everyone. It depends how much you use Laravel. Basically, the first thing to think about is that this exam, it's for Laravel 5.5. So it's not for, we're on Laravel 5.8 now. So you don't really want to be looking through the documentation at the Laravel 5.8 stuff, because you're going to be revising things that are not even going to be in the exam. So make sure when you're looking at the docs to put the version at 5.5 to start with, because then you're only looking at things that you could be tested on. The exam is multiple choice. There's four answers for each question, but the main thing to bear in mind is that if you get a question wrong, they will deduct a point from your overall total. So if you don't know a question, the answer to a question, you're better off just leaving the answer blank and not answering it. If you try and guess the ones that you don't know, you could end up failing, because you'll end up with a lot less marks than you think. So basically, the exam is done through a software called Proctor, which is just a Chrome extension that you install in your Chrome browser. And that records your webcam, sound, and records your screen as well. So there's no point trying to cheat, because you won't be able to cheat it. They're watching you every second, so there's no way you're not allowed to have any notes. You pretty much just got to know everything from memory. There's a few bits specifically that I would look at if just to get the basics. I noticed quite a lot of questions on middleware. So if you go to basics and then middleware, I'm pretty sure I got about 4 questions on middleware. I think there was about 40 or 45 questions overall in the exam. So that's quite a big chunk if there's 5 questions on it. And there's definitely one that I know that I got wrong. There was one that I didn't answer as well, about this terminable middleware. So it was saying at what point would this be called, this method? And my first thought was that it would be when something goes wrong, but it's actually just before the request is handled. So I left that blank, which means I didn't get a point for it and I didn't get a point deducted. So definitely just leave it blank if you don't know. And then there's another one that I also got, that I actually think I got wrong as well. It was a question asking about this before and after middleware. And it was saying if you wanted to run a middleware before a request and after a request, would you be able to do that in one middleware, or would you have separate middleware? And in my head, I thought that you could just have a before and after method in the middleware, which you actually can't. I must have just been looking at remembering this before and after when I've looked at the docs. But you do actually have to have separate middleware for that. So another thing that I noticed there was a lot of questions about was roots. So where's that now? Routing. So I would definitely look at routing and middleware. I got a question about why you would use what is it now? I think why would you use ri named roots? And I'm pretty sure I got it right, but it was one of the answers was if you change your URLs in your project, all your links will still point to the right route because you're using the name, not the URL. There was a question that I had to leave on this as well, the patterns. I'd never even looked at that before, so I just didn't want to risk guessing it. But it was asking how you would do this, and it's one of the answers was pattern, so that's probably the right answer, but I just left that. I think I got about an hour to do with the test, so it was if there was 45 questions, then it's not much time on each one. So what I did was go through quickly. If there was any that I definitely knew, I'd answer them. Any that I wasn't sure about fully, I'd just skip. And then at the end, you get an overview, like an overview list where you can see ones that you've not answered yet. So I went to there and then just worked through each one, and I pretty much just an I answered the last one that I knew as the test finished. So you definitely only just get enough time to do it. Just trying to think if there's anything else. I think you get two goes at the exam. So if you do fail it the first time, you should get another go in with the prize. So hopefully that would take a bit of pressure off the first time that you do it, but then if you do have to use your second go, then the obvious is there's more pressure when you do it the second time. When you pass, you just get an email with a PDF certificate, but then I think you can verify it with this link. So that's how potential employers can check that it's a valid certificate. Actually, there was one more thing that I wanted to. Yeah, I got asked a lot of questions about serialization, which I thought meant some kind of like encrypting, but it's actually just converting data to JSON or from JSON to an array. So it's probably worth having a read of this as well. There was definitely like two or three questions on just on serialization. I'm not sure how big the question bank is for this, but I'm guessing there'll be a few questions that I got on your test as well. Apart from that, obviously Eloquent, there was a few questions. I think it was like one or two questions on Eloquent and Eloquent relationships. So knowing which one of these relationships to use at which time, which a lot of them are pretty self-explanatory with how they are worded, but it's good just to have a refresher before you do the test. Yeah, and then there was quite a few questions on like specific parts of the framework where you would find this and things like that. So it was saying like where you would add providers and things like that. So this part here in the config slash app dot php is where you would add the providers, and there was definitely a question on that. So that's one thing that you could memorize, and just being familiar with the config and the actual framework layout of where all the files are. But yeah, apart from that, if you've got any questions about the exam, I've literally just taken it and passed it. So if you've got any questions, put them in the comments and I'll answer each one. I have got another video coming up about using Vue and Axios to do Ajax calls with CRUD. So quite a few people have been asking for that type of tutorial, but it's going to take me quite a long time to do that, so I might have to do that this weekend. But yeah, make sure you subscribed and like the video if you want some more Laravel and Vue tutorials. And I'll catch you in the next video. Cheers.